And we did, somebody talked about testicular derived sperm. So we did testicular derived sperm, ICSI, PGS, and there's an ongoing pregnancy. You can argue why PGS, I think, is because of her previous three failed ART cycles. We were compelled to do something extra. Now, again, I'm not here to actually tell you all to go away from the tunnel testing, but it just, again, more data showing that the COMET is more predictive of what the outcome is in an ART cycle. This is a paper that we published in 2015, and we looked at the live birth rate. Fine, there is a direct association between sperm DNA fragmentation and miscarriage, but is there any effect on the live birth rate? And, you know, is this some problem for the progeny? So we did a systematic review, and actually we found that the live birth rate significantly is decreased when you have a sample with sperm DNA fragmentation. One of the secondary outcomes was to check if there were any genetic defects, birth genetic defects, in men who have a raised DNA fragmentation, have a live birth, is there genetic defects? And we didn't have any studies that have reported that. Implications of sperm DNA fragment damage to the health of future generations. And again, there's a lot of anecdotal case reports in the medical literature. Does it reduce longevity? I'm not suggesting all of my male colleagues go and do their DNA fragmentation, but there is a thought that it could increase the risk of cancer in the offspring. You know, possibly bowel cancer, some of the reported literature. Conclusions is very, very simple. Lifestyle modification, epigenetics, sperm DNA fragmentation testing, of course, that I've shown you the evidence for. ROS, I have not put that in because the problem with ROS testing, I'm sure my colleague would agree, it depends on the half-life, because if you leave the sperm out for too long and then you measure it, the ROS changes within hours of the sperm production. So the question is, how soon after the sperm production do you do the ROS testing? After half an hour? Or after you've done the basic semen analysis, after 2 hours? And if you look at the medical literature, the Professor Aitken, who talked about ROS testing with the Lumina test, talks about doing it after 2 hours. Is 2 hours good enough as a prediction? Because we all know that the ROS goes up, and if you leave the sample on the bench for about 12 hours, your ROS would hit the roof. So I don't know what the answer for the ROS testing is. But that's where I work, and we run the recurrent miscarriage clinic, and the male partners are seen separately during their workup by the nurse, you know, an evaluation form. So what we're trying to evaluate is a sperm, sort of a male partner pathway for recurrent miscarriages as well as male fertility issues. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ms. Kushadri, for your wonderful presentation. And I'm sure it was very thought-provoking. And so if there are any questions, maybe we can address one or two, because we're running short of time.
Do you test only once, or do you repeat the test?
Before you make an important statement, because there's a lot happening after the test is said positive.
Are you alluding to the sperm DNA fragmentation? We do it once because of the predictive value with the COMET. With the tunnel, we used to do the tunnel before, but the thing is, the predictive value, if you look at all the literature that I've put up, the predictive value for a tunnel is 44%. So you're not sure, is this the right answer? So then you repeat it. But with the COMET, I just do one test, I give them their lifestyle sheet, modification sheet, and then we repeat it 6 weeks later.
When you repeat, what percentage difference do you see? Like,
It depends on patient compliance, and quite often is the population that we work with in North London, they're not very compliant to our instructions. So I haven't seen a drastic drop in the DNA fragmentation, but the spontaneous conception, I haven't presented that data because it's very small numbers to go with. But Professor Lewis, who we work with the COMET, who runs the COMET assay, she thinks that there is a spontaneous conception rate of 30% in couples with recurrent miscarriage.
Common